clean cuts. I'm wide eyed, your eyes are shut. If I'm knocked out, look at the distance. Pound for pound, we're a perfect match. Pulling punches, a toe to toe, we're always on the road. Worse or better, we can't stop, we can't stop. Cause together, better off than we can. Oh,
Okay, let's see if that's working. Right. Oh God, that is awful. Okay, right, well, this is the first time I have streamed on Twitch in nearly 2 years. I don't know how well this is going to do. Hello. Welcome to the stream. I am Hopeless, aka Gary. I have a YouTube channel. I've got the house to myself, so I figured, why not get started with all this stuff? I need to try and do something in my free time. Right. So, if I go into that, that's all set up there. I don't even know what to do. Maybe try and find some music that's not god awful. Or is going to get me like copyright struck and... Let's try that one. Let's skip that one. That seems right. I reckon. Test this out. I've got one of these. It's from a Kickstarter for Cats of Crumptown. It's like Dungeons and Dragons classes. Is that on autofocus? It's looking a little bit shiny in places. I had a slight accident earlier. I spilt a load of 3D printer resin over my counter and some of it got on some models. So, yeah, let's make sure I can... Yeah, it's all dry, it's fine. So... This is what looks like a skinless, or hair skinless, that's awful. A hairless Egyptian cat as a thief. Now I should really try doing this with a little bit more planning ahead, I think. I reckon. I need to remember where the hell all my paints are. Oh, there we go. There we are, that's a bit better. I hope this is coming through okay. Maybe do an hour or so. Maybe two. Also gives me a chance to use out these new brushes. Because again, I dropped resin over the other ones, so I'm going to be using these nice BrokenToad brushes. Should be fun. Yeah, that's better. I think I've started this on the wrong foot, but we will proceed. Actually, go to the eyes, let's fill those in later. Ooh, right. Ears. So I'm still getting used to doing this. Normally it's recording videos, which I can go back over and sort out in editing. But I can't really do that live. This should be fine. Oh, why is it doing that? I'm gonna test. Of course. Alright, hopefully. Unless I succeed. Too bright. Right, let's see if that does anything. Turn that off. Yeah, that's fine. Right. Fingers crossed that will be fine. Hoping the resin that's spilled on here doesn't affect the paint. Afraid of old brush. There's a reason I don't wear clean clothes doing this. Right, it's okay, try again. This is Gilman's Flesh contrast paint. I quite like using this. I think it helps me out quite a bit. Oh, of course, keep hitting the camera. Trying to work out if that is skin or a glove. I'm gonna take a chance. I know the hands will be flesh. I gotta take a chance. If I'm wrong, I can paint over it again later. Hmm. Yeah, I think I got that wrong. Although, actually, no, because these hairless cats look quite wrinkly. Yeah, actually, no, I think that'll work. Yeah, you can see a sleeve in there. I think it'll work. I don't even know how half this stuff does it. I'll do the feet so I can sort the base out later. Still tweaking. I think I'll do. Good. I need to try and get this resin out though. Hopefully the paint will cover that. I do like the cloak. Let's try and see what I can get in. Do do. All right, come on, load. Come on. That's right. Sorry, my girlfriend is out of parents at the moment. Right, back to what I was doing. Been on for online for half an hour, apparently. Now then, what to do? I don't want to use too much of this. I like using contrast paints, but I don't want to over rely on it at times. Ooh. Now, should I try something? I don't really know too much about brushes. I just sort of use what I like. I'm also not too fussed about not being neat at the moment, because I can go over this in a bit. I have a slight plan for this torch. I think this is probably one of the better Kickstarters I've backed recently. Try to get it off of it. Very subtle attempt at wet blending. Little duck. I think that looks quite nice. Little yellow strip at the top of the lamp. think that came out. That, I think that works. Should. Bear with me 2 seconds. Someone from works. Sorry about that, cleaners at work. Let's see if they can handle that. Right. It's a quick drink while I try and work out whether work can survive without me for a moment. Right, so we got that. Now I reckon. Which one's that? Bright gold. Haha. I reckon this will be good stuff. Oops. Let's try this. This is Creature Caster Pro Acrylic Bronze. I've done this a little bit too thin. I will try and work out a better way of laying things out around here. That's actually quite nice. Just chilling out and doing this. Sorry, our cleaners are trying to work out how to work the aircon controls. Go, go, go. I will check out what they've sent me as soon as I've done this. So they sent me a picture of air conditioning controls, and I'm trying to remember what they do. Oh, just realized I missed a bit on the thing. If I keep headbutting this damn camera, no one's gonna see anything. There we go. Now, I'm going to say, options for copyright, non-copyright music are very poor. If it's up to me, we have a bit of Sabaton. Right. Just try and make this look not so shallow. Also want to try and keep these brushes in fairly decent condition. Nice. Is that focus? Look at that. That's definitely the best flames I've done today. Aircon. Right. Let's get the little. Oh, that was a little brush. Right, so that's good. Now the cloak. What can I use for the cloak? There's a bit. Alright, let me check my little paperwork. I've got all my contrast paints painted on here. Let's see. Hairless cats. Where are they coming from? Six cats. What colour eyes do you got? Ooh, we've got sort of a bluey one. That's interesting. Blues, blues, blues. I don't want a dark blue, slate blue, deep teal, electric blue, midnight blue. Oh, that was the wrong button to hit. Google search for hairless cats is the weirdest thing you'll ever see. That's actually... Ooh, I like that. There's a picture here. One eye's blue, one eye's yellow. I could work with that. I need a pale blue. Or some like grey blue would be a... No. Slate. Oh, maybe. I don't know. Do I have pure blue? Electric blue. Dark blue. You know what? I actually don't. That's weird. No, no, no. Think. Let me try something. Bit of electric. And a pure white. We're supposed to be doing the hood, but the eye is now sort of... Could work. Maybe. So that was, I'm using Instar paints for this one. Instar Alpha Electric Blue and a bit of white. Generally, eyes are not my strong point. That's a bit nice. I need to sort the colour balance out here. I think I definitely need to try and work out the music a bit better. That's quite nice. Oh, that's me knocking brushes everywhere. The other one, a bit of beach sand. Don't want too much. Focus. Mm. keep headbutting that camera. What the hell is that? No. That'll work. That works good there. I just realized there's a little bit on top of his ear that's a bit. Well, that might be where the resin fell on it earlier. Alright. We'll need to do that color. That yellow again, I think. That's okay. That should be fine. Now, parchments. I quite like not headbutting cameras, but as well as that, I know Skeletal Horde from Contrast does the aged parchment quite well. So that will be what we use here. I got my nice big brush, so she's stolen all of these papers, or it could be maps. It's all been whacked into her bag. She's making a nice little getaway. To be fair, I've complained about the music, but that last one was quite nice and relaxed. I quite like that. I like the sculpts on these. Very cartoony. Very much my style of thinking. I gotta try something. May or may not work. My thinking is that where I knocked the resin over earlier and it splashed up on there, fire it up in the UV light I've got, set it up. Shouldn't take too long. But while that's doing that, I can bring up the other one I've got. Bit of resin. Actually, that was the cleaning stuff. Didn't fully get off of there. I'm waiting for this to drain. That's quite nice, isn't it? Looking forward to painting that one later. Right. Give that another couple of seconds. I've got so much crap around me right now. Let's have a look at that. How did that? Well, I reckon the only way we'll know is by finishing this off. Let's give that iron another going over. Yeah, it could work. Right. Hood. What can I do with the hood? I'm not looking forward to actually doing the pupils because I suck at doing eyes. Maybe a deep green. Maybe. dark green, forest green. Now I keep spotting places I missed on the skin. Could work, which is gonna be my catchphrase, I think. Do I go? Yeah, I reckon that'll work. Bit of Instar Alpha Forest Green. Let's see how this goes on the cloak. Go for the bigger brush. Yeah, it could work. As I said, I'm not... I think I rely too much on contrast paints nowadays. Which is what I'm trying to avoid doing on this one too much. Happily use it on the skin of anything I'm working on, but I don't want to be like throw it all over the miniature if I can help it. And then maybe one day I'll get a camera lens that will stay in focus or have an infinite focus. I don't think they exist too much nowadays. Or do I risk manual automatic focus? It could work. I stick to manual focusing when I'm doing videos for YouTube, but again, that's easier to correct in editing. One day I will get this set up as well so I don't headbutt the camera every time I move. Like so. starting to wonder if I've got a fingerprint on my lens. Just a very faint glow. I need something a little bit more uplifting on the music. See how that one goes. Yeah, a bit better. It's always good when you don't hit the face. Now, if I could avoid getting green on the rest of the flesh, I would be happy. I think I will have to go over that strap though. Getting there. Is my wet palette drying out slightly? Maybe. Right, let's try that again. Right, I'm gonna try and keep my hands steady. I will go over the strap of the bag with the grey again. I have an idea for that. Right, well, I think that's going to be a nightmare to paint. Get the paintbrush in there with a different colour, so I'm just going to... I have a very simple rule if it comes to a hard to paint bit that's not really going to be seen, and that is I will do it one colour. Oh, that's okay. Ah, you bugger.
Great.
Hit the one bit I didn't want to hit. It's alright, I will redo that as well. But it's fine. Yeah, that works. I might have done this completely the wrong way around. Maybe I should have done the inner bits rather than the outside of the click. Oh well. We can work around these things. It's getting there. It is getting there. Is that all of the hood? Is that the hood all done? Possibly. Well, that sort of works. There we go. Right. Well, while that is drying, I'm going to redo that arm. Otherwise, I will forget and it will look awful. That's Green Stuff World Matte Surface Primer. Just do from the forearm. Yeah, if I do from the forearm, it won't make the contrast look odd. And while I'm doing that, I might as well just go over the bag. And the strap. Just need to wait for that to dry. Now while that is, I can have a look. And a quick drink. So we've got some sort of tunic underneath, a little drinking flask, a little bag. Bag with the stolen maps or whatever. And leggings. What I might do is go over the muzzle and the nose when I'm doing the arm again. Just sort of darken up the contrast, maybe a little bit around the eyes. Sort of hide where I went over with the yellow. Hello, while that's swip of budget energy drink. Thank you. I'm gonna admit, it might seem really simple, but I think that lamp's actually come out quite nicely with the glow on the inside. I don't normally try shit like that. And that's okay. Cleaners have got the air conditioning working, which is good because I wasn't really planning on going into work today. Think. I think red. I reckon red for the undercoat. Or maybe both. Maybe undercoat and leggings. No. I'm just going to go for red tunic. I think brown leggings. I'm not going to be massively tidy in there. That bit. Oh, did I miss a bit of resin? How's that? Is it noticeable? That is the important thing. No, that's not. And if you have no idea what I'm on about, that's good. I think that works. Oh, I'm not looking forward to doing the eyes. I really ain't. Go for brown. I've got a dark brown there. I'll go for a light brown. Do I have a light brown? Rust. I'll have a rust. Rust brown, and then a wash. Mainly because the legs are not actually, or the trousers aren't that visible. And the rust brown, what was rust, yeah. Rust brown's pretty light, so I can use a wash over that. Too sure whether this was skin or trousers, but it could be either. Could go either way. To be fair, once that dries, I can go over that with one of the contrasts. I like using the contrast as washes. Not quite sure why. Dry enough to do flesh again. There we go. Right. I did say I was going to go over the muzzle again. Just to darken it up a bit. Go over the mouth as well. I'll go over the nose with a different colour later. Hide the eyes a little bit. Yeah, that works. Exactly, a nice one. I realise how hypocritical this is by saying I don't want to use contrast paints too much, and then my next one is a contrast. However, this is one of the lightest contrast paints they've got, and works quite well to pinken up areas. Magos Purple. To be fair, inside of the ears. there. Once that dries, that'll come out quite nicely. And then another contrast paint to do the bag. I think contrast works better for skin tones and highly detailed areas. Stuff where there's a lot of texture. Which, funnily enough, is stuff that I struggle on. Well, I say struggle. Just areas that I don't want to spend too much time buggering up. Oh no, I don't want to say that because that makes me sound lazy. I think contrast paints have a use, and I intend to make them. Ooh, concentrate. I intend to make as much use of them as possible, while trying not to rely on them too much. Backpack. Now I'm just going to do a little bit on each of these and then do the details in different colours. Focus. That's the way you're looking. Right, so while they are drying, I'm going to go back over the bits that I seem to have missed. just little bits underneath. And I went over you with the red. That's fine. And I missed a bit there. Make the eye a little bit less noticeable there. Right, so that's all done. Just need to do details on the drinking horn pouch. There's nothing on there. Let's try and do something with this hood. Give it a bit of texture or shading. What have I got? Could be interesting. I don't think the plague bearer flesh is going to have much of an effect. Warp lightning might, however. Quite a nice, a bright green to go. I have no idea how this is going to go, actually. This is mainly... Forest green base. Oh, I might have put a bit too much on there. I don't know, this could go either way. This could look bloody awful, or it could actually come out looking relatively alright. But that's the fun in what I do, or the way I do things. No plan, just wing it. And to be fair, we'll only really see when it's dry. Oh God, please no. No, 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 no. This is not the sort of music I want. Might be a... We'll not judge it too quickly. That's not too bad. That's... I mean, the green, I'm not too sure about the music. I mean, if it stays like this, the music's fine. Actually... Actually, I quite quite like that. I might change my mind when it's dry, but at the moment, so I didn't just get green on that. Oh, I did. Actually, it's all right. I can do that. That's a solid metallic color. I can just go over that again. Yeah, no. I think the more I look at it, the more I like it. Dark base. Dark green base. Warp lightning over the top. Strangely, this looks more forest green than the forest green does. This is how that green should have came out, I reckon. I'm just not looking forward to doing pupils. That's where I struggle on. But I'm going to ignore that for the moment. Let's have... let's touch up that bit there, the bronze. Ooh, what's happened to my brush? Bronze there, and then do the drinking fountain. The drinking cup, that's the word I'm looking for. Yep, smacking my head against the camera. That's the only way to get close to these details. should be alright. Bronze or silver? I'll let it dry, and then I'll come back to it. Right, no putting this off. I have a pot of heavily, heavily thinned down Abaddon Black. And 3/0 brush from miniature from a BrokenToad. Right. Okay. I hate doing eyes. Oh my God. I'm so happy I managed to actually do that first time. Generally, to do other eyes on anything, it takes me about an hour, and I am cocktail stick pin-pricking these things. Actually, no, I'm quite happy with that. I'm not even going to try playing about that, because, yeah, I ain't going to fuck that up. Wow. Look at that. That's nice. Let's try and dry that off a little bit. Just ignore the compressor in the background. Just trying to dry this off. I'm thinking I'm having second thoughts about the colour on the drinking fountain. So I'm thinking maybe practical silver for the buttons. Yeah, that'll work a bit better, I think. Unblock it. Quite a nice, there's a nice silver. I like these silvers. I like these metallics. There you go. So it looks better already to me. Hell yeah. Oh, I like that. That's better than I thought it'd be. Of course, I just realised this lamp has a handle. And I can do that very quickly. Done. Perfect. Now, I guess see the Magos purple in the ears actually did what I hoped it would. I'm just wondering. Do I try? See, this is where it all starts going wrong for me. Because I then start trying to tweak and improve upon. And you know what? I'm actually quite happy with how that looks. In fact, I think the only thing that I'm going to do is sort the base out. How long have I had? Oh, over 2 hours. This is actually quite nice. I would call this a successful first stream. I'll rephrase that. Last time I streamed to Twitch was about 2 years ago, and that was playing video games. This is the first time I have streamed to Twitch trying to paint miniatures. I'm hoping it's coming out right on the other end. I can see a few people have been in and out of the room. People can lurk if they want. I'm not the most overly chatty person. But if people want to hang around, they can. If not, plenty of other channels on Twitch. But I have enjoyed this. And if anyone is out there watching this now, I hope they're enjoying it too. I don't have a system or a schedule set up as of yet. However, as the lockdown has started easing off in the UK, and I have actually started returning to work, my current plan will be to try and stream after my shifts. Now, I work in a cinema, so I'll be working most nights till 11. Of course, that would depend on whether, if anyone wants to risk it going out in the current climate. Although walking past all the pubs last couple of nights, yeah, people definitely want to go out. It's whether they want to go to a cinema. Also, depends on what films we get. Now, normally I like to take a bit of care and attention to my bases, but as I've done the rookie mistake of gluing these straight into the slots, I'm going to have to try and be a bit creative. Which it can be. Well, I like to think it can be. Again, if you are watching this and you want to know a little bit more about what I have done, I have social links down below, Twitter, that I'm slowly getting back into using again. Instagram, where I mainly post pictures of what I've painted, and my YouTube channel, where I post the videos of me painting these. So if that's something you are interested in, please do check it out. There's a couple of affiliate links as well. A bit of shopping never hurt anyone. Also need to try and justify to my girlfriend about how much time I spend doing this stuff. Right, once that's dry, get the old trusty airbrush out again. That's good. Excuse me. Not quite. All day. Think. What have I got around here? Oh. Fabius. His associates. There you go. That'd be nice. I reckon I can do that. Let's get that down there. Got some army paint of battlefield brown battleground. Crappy texture tool. Yeah, that'll do. Spread that out. I don't really care if it affects the paint too much on the base. That's okay. Spread that underneath there. Gonna give him a little shuffle in. I do actually have a little tray that I use for this that I've put somewhere and I cannot find it now. Nice, simple, quick base. Although, once he dries, what is tacky? Something is tacky and I keep rubbing my fingers over it. Ah, might be the resin. So this is the Thief from the Cats of Crumpton set. This is me. I've been painting this for over 2 hours, 15 minutes. I'm quite happy where it came out. Really impressed with the lamp. I'm quite happy with the lamp and the eyes. I've got about half of these built up. That was a Thief. Oh, I've got my little box here. And there's a Fighter. There you go, do it that way. Got the Fighter, I've just done the Thief, there's a Wizard, there's a Ranger, Barbarian, Rogue, Paladin, Warlock, Cleric. Let's zoom out a bit. See my messy, messy workspace. Yeah, Cleric, Druid, Bard, Monk. Yeah, I just realised there is actually resin on this. Didn't get it all. Yeah, it was a quite a good little Kickstarter. Northumbrian Tin Soldier, highly recommend going and checking those guys out. In fact, let me just move the cameras. That was me unplugging the camera accidentally. Let's try that again. So yeah, I got a couple of bits over there. The Dark Cat, and sort of the Death Grim Reaper of the cat world. Ooh, drop the face first, that's always a good sign. Little Knight. Got a little Luna. Just ignore how messy it is behind there. Little cat who's dressed up as a dragon. Yeah, I got some other bits that I was gonna toy around with painting on here instead of the Thief. I will sort this desk out as well. Got another Northumbrian Tin Soldier in the background there. I was just messing about with the color scheme on that. Woo! Yeah, this is my painting setup. This is how I do things. And this is me on Twitch. I'm gonna say I need a cup of tea and maybe something to eat. So I'm gonna call it there. It was quite a successful little stream in my mind. If anyone is still there, thank you for watching. Give us a follow if you wanna catch up with me whenever I'm on here. It's always nice. And yeah. Till the next time, thanks for watching. Cheers.